Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So I thought I would do a different video, and this is a will I buy it video. There's so many new releases coming out, and I feel like even at this time of the year it's slowed down a little bit, but there's still so many things that have been coming out. And you know, I usually just sort of sit at my computer and I kind of flip through the like new arrivals on the Sephora site and the Neiman Marcus site, the Bergdorf site, and some other of my favorite places, Beautylish. And I thought, you know what, why don't we just kind of go through it together and I can get your comments down below and see if there's anything that you guys really, really want me to try out. So there are a few things that I kind of pulled out. Again, there's so many things that I was like, all right, let me just talk about the things that I feel like I would at least be tempted by and kind of just go through my thought process with you. So the first one is the NARS Radiant Foundation, and I'm going to flash pictures up of all these products. But the NARS Radiant Foundation, when I saw the title of it, I really wanted to try this foundation. I really like radiant dewy foundations because I have dry skin, I'm getting older, I'm getting more mature. But I saw a couple of reviews and everyone seems to have concluded that it really isn't that radiant. It's just not totally matte. But it's just sort of like a skin-like texture. So, and I haven't personally had a lot of luck with NARS foundations in the past. They always seem to kind of break me out, but I was willing to give this one a shot, but I think I'm gonna pass on this one because I just don't think it has the finish that I was expecting or was looking for. The other NARS release is that like little six pan palette, and it has like a mirrored pink front, and I think maybe it's like a Sephora exclusive, but it has six colors in there and they're all really shimmery. It kind of reminds me of the Kevin Aucoin Electro Pop palette that just came out. It just has like really shimmery kind of like accent colors in there. I'm definitely passing on this. I just don't find that this would be a palette that I would reach for often. These just aren't shadows that I would use, you know, regularly, and then to have an entire palette of them, I just don't think would be worth it. So I'm definitely passing on that as well. So another product I saw on the Sephora site that I was really interested in was the Lila B Cream Highlighter. It comes in their pebble casing, you know, kind of like flips out. It's like this heavy metal, but it even has like a kind of a different finish to it. So generally the packaging is white, but this one is sort of this like metallic bronze color. So beautiful. I love cream highlights, but I just don't know... I just don't know that I need another one. So this one is definitely a maybe for me. I love Lila B, I love the brand, I love everything that I've purchased from them. I really like that they do things that are very, very subtle. I'm expecting this cream highlighter to be a very subtle one, you know, not to be like an Instagram highlight. It's just gonna be this really nice, you know, kind of like subtle highlight to the skin. And I like that. And I really like their packaging, I really like the company. But again, I just don't know if I need any more cream highlights. So this one is a definite maybe. I think maybe with the Sephora Spring VIB sale, maybe I'll pick it up, but I don't know that I'm gonna rush to get this one. So we'll see, we'll see. Let me know if you guys are curious about it down below. And then Becca came out with what I saw to be like five new products. So they have like a highlighter palette, they have that round eyeshadow palette, they have a new lip gloss, they have the under eye primer, like that anti-fatigue primer, and then an under eye setting powder. So I've already just purchased the under eye setting powder and the primer. I got those two things. The other three things I'm gonna pass on. The highlighter palette looked like it had maybe one or two shades in there that I would use and like, but the others looked, you know, like of that holographic unicorn family. And I love those, I think they're really fun, but I just don't use those enough. And I have a few of those in my collection already, like the Anastasia Moonchild. I'm like, that's enough. I don't really need any more of those. So I'm definitely gonna pass on the highlighter palette. The eyeshadow palette, it's okay. It looks pretty, you know, purple definitely seems to be, purple and cool tones definitely seem to be the trend nowadays. This palette looks, again, it looks very, very pretty, but it just doesn't, I don't know, it doesn't like blow my skirt up. I'm not like, oh, I'm not like immediately excited about it. So I think I am gonna pass on it. The lip gloss I'm definitely gonna pass on. It doesn't seem like something that would kind of do much to the lips. I think I saw some YouTuber Young, Wild, and Polished. I think she put it on and was like, eh, like it didn't really do as much as it looks like it would do in the tube. Like it really looks like it's going to be like crystally or whatever, but it didn't look like it did much. So I'm definitely going to pass on that. But I did purchase the under eye stuff. That should be coming today or tomorrow, and I definitely want to try that for you guys. Because my under eye issue, I don't really have dark circles, but I have puffiness. And I think that this primer really addresses puffiness, so I'm stoked. I really want to try that, and then I want to try that powder. So that is definitely coming. So this I've been hemming and hawing about for a really long time, and I feel like there's been no buzz about this, but Makeup Forever came out, like basically reformulated all of their shadows and like changed the size of the pan. I think actually there's more product, but now they're rectangular instead of circles. And I have a whole bunch of Makeup Forever shadows and I love them. They are just workhorse shadows. They never ever, they're kind of like Visiguard. They're never any surprises. They work exactly the way you want them to work. And I just love them. They're just like rock solid shadows. And then for them to reformulate them, I'm like, oh my God, I don't know. So I kind of want to get a couple of shades that I already have and kind of compare the two formulas and then pick up some new ones and just play around with it. And then some things that I saw on like the department store sites, like Nordstrom or Bergdorf or Neiman's or Saks or whatever. So Charlotte Tilbury, this was another thing. I don't know when these came out, but it looks like she expanded her lip cheat, her lip liners, to kind of follow suit with a lot of her popular lipsticks like Bond Girl, Walk of Shame. So these are all new to the lip liner line, but not new to the lipstick line. And so, I don't know, I have most of those lipsticks, and I thought, do I need lip liners that match exactly to those lipsticks? I'm not sure. I do love her lip liners. It's one of my favorite things from her line. So I think maybe I'll pick up maybe like one or two just to see. Maybe I'll go through my lip liner collection and see if I have any colors that I'm like missing. Maybe Bond Girl I think is one that I'm missing. But definitely thinking about that. She also has some new lipstick colors and I don't know. I think I'm going to pass on those. I think there's two new Matte Revolution colors and one new Kissing formula color. And I much prefer her Kissing formula. That's like the more creamy one. But I don't like the color that it comes in. It's a little bit too pink. So anyway, so maybe I'll get some of the lip liners, but I don't think I'm going to pick up any of her new lipsticks. The Armani Face Fabric, that is the new foundation that comes in that like squeezy tube. I think I'm definitely passing on this one. This one seems to be like that full coverage, long wear matte foundation, which is, it's not for me. It's not my friend. So I think I'm going to skip on that. Clé de Peau came out with a whole bunch of new lip glosses, radiant lip glosses. They, I think, all have like a little bit of shimmer to them, which is why they're called radiant lip glosses. I may pick up one or two. There's one, like the lightest color, which is like a crystally color, looks appealing to me. And then there's one that's like a nude. So I may pick up those two shades. I'm not quite sure. I think what I'm going to do is go to the store because I've seen them. Is it at Saks? No, I saw them at Neiman Marcus. They were actually in the case. Yeah, I may swatch those and pick up one or two. But I mean, I'm kind of a sucker for lip gloss and I really do like Clé de Peau, so it's kind of a no-brainer. Sisley is coming out with new eyeliners that have a metallic glint to them. I've seen this trend. I think Ciate maybe did this. But you know, you put it on, it has a little bit of glitter on there, but then you rub it. Or was it Fenty? Fenty Beauty did that. And you rub it and like the glitter becomes more pronounced. So Sisley just came out with some eyeliners like that, so I think I may pick up some of those. I haven't seen them in store yet. I've only seen them on the Sisley site, but once they're in store, I want to go and kind of like see which colors I want and get some of those, because that sounds fun. Chanel's spring line is one I'm going to pass on completely. It's really bright, like these really, really bright colors, like there's like a teal green and a yellow and like an orange leaning red, and there's like a nine pan palette, and those colors just don't speak to me. Yeah, I just don't see myself wearing any of those colors, so I'm gonna pass on all of those. Oh, I was very, very tempted by the Ombre Premier, the cream shadow in the pot. It's like a deeper green. I was tempted by it, but I thought I'm probably not gonna use it that often, so I kind of skipped on that. So I'm passing on the entire Chanel spring line. And then there have been two blush releases that I'm very, very tempted by. So Jouer came out with those blush duos. there's three different colorways. I think one's like pink, one's like peachy nude, and one is more of a berry. I'm really tempted by the peachy nude. I think one pan is like matte and one pan is shimmer. I really love that idea. I love Jouer. They're a great brand. The packaging looks really, really pretty. So I may be picking that up. I'm not totally in a rush to get it, but that's definitely on the list. So the last thing that has intrigued me is Shantikai has come out with, I don't think they've reached the stores yet, I've been waiting very impatiently. They have all of these powder blushes. Now none of these colors, I believe, are new to the line. I think previously were only sold in single pans and then you could put it into their pebble compact or into their big palette. So what they've done is they've put them into the little compact and they've embossed them with, I think, all of the charities that they work with. So there's like a coral one, a bee one, I'm sure there's like a horse one. So I definitely want to pick up some of those. I feel like they're limited edition, so I feel like they're going to be like collector items, but I'll still be able to use them because they're existing blushes in their line, and you guys could get the colors if you wanted to, even if it wasn't in the same exact packaging. I'm waiting for those to hit the store. I'm probably going to pick up at least a couple of those because I really, really like the Shantikai powder products. They're just so finely milled, just really, really elegant, elegant products. So I am excited for those. So those are some of my thoughts on some new releases that are coming out. Let me know what you guys think down below. Let me know if there's some new releases that have intrigued you, you're not sure about them, maybe I would want to get them and I can test them out for you. Let me know down below. So if you like this kind of video, it's new for me, let me know by giving it a thumbs up, and that way I'll know to do more of these in the future. And please don't forget to subscribe down below. I'll see you in my next video.